पीछे गिरेंगे भाई।
अरे पीछे फुल पीछे भाई, ले मेरे फुल पीछे।
Hello, very, very warm welcome to Sunny Leone, who joined us over here today and made this conference even more special. Sunny, we're going to
thank you
so much for doing so much work as an actress, you're doing so much work as an entrepreneur. Which role is it that you really like? And you know, how do you sort of balance both these roles? There's so much to do for you at the end of the day.
I think the most fulfilling thing
would be creating something new, being
an entrepreneur. My husband and I have been working so hard for so long, and I'm sure there's many people here who will agree with me. When you see this small something, whether it's a product or a brand or an idea or a thought or a dream, and you watch it from the ground up grow, it is the best. I feel goosebumps. It is the best feeling to watch something, you know, that is a dream or an idea, and all of a sudden it's in your hands now. So that's the most fulfilling.
So, you know, you're a global star. You've lived in Canada most of your life, and then you moved to India. So as a celebrity, as a star, what was it that prompted you to sort of come to India, and then, of course, to come into Bollywood, which is very, very competitive by its own self, and also then to be an entrepreneur? So what prompted you to be, to your shift from Canada to India?
My shift from the U.S. to here was not something that I planned. It wasn't something that I said, hey, let's go to India tomorrow and work. That wasn't, you know, the plan in my head. But my husband was talking to Color, which is Big Boss, and that's, you know, how it happened. I said yes to the show, and the rest is history. And now I'm here. Been here for a very long time now. And the entrepreneur part, I was the little kid that went door to door selling things to people. So my first business was shoveling snow and making lemonade for, I think the most I ever made shoveling snow was $3. It was a great day because that meant 300 pieces of candy. I was very young. And so, lemonade is another thing that, you know, as a child, that it's great to own your own lemonade stand.
So now your day over here at the Naval's Conference has a license in your show, and you're launching the famous line of cosmetics. Also, you're doing boys fashion wear line. You're a fashion diva yourself. So what does really fashion mean to you? What does it imply? And, you know, how does it don't make you even more beautiful?
Sure, I'm just going to correct the names of the products or the brands. The first one is Starstruck, which is a cosmetic line that my husband and I launched last year, and it's doing, thank God, very well, and we're very happy. Women are happy wearing my product. It's something that, again, that I worked really hard on. I tested the products myself for over the last, I can't even tell you for how long. It's a little obsessive to make sure that it's perfect. And the innerwear lingerie is something that we're going to launch next, and it'll be called Infamous Lingerie by Sammy Leone. So I'm excited about that. That's something that is new and exciting, and you know, the next step.
You know, so ladies and gentlemen, for some of you who don't know out there, she is the most Google star celebrity in the world. And when you have that kind of global following, and when you have that kind of fandom, not just in India, but outside India as well, you have a huge responsibility that comes with it. You know, they always look up to you and expect you to do something for everything which is probably going to make them happy, but at the same time, it puts a serious amount of responsibility on you. So whenever you take a brand or you take any kind of endorsement, how do you sort of balance this? You know, how do you balance your fandom to say that while it has to be commercially manageable, but it also has to be responsible to my fans?
If it's a brand that I don't own and that I'm endorsing, it just, for me, it has to be something that I like or I would use, or that is not going to cause harm, bodily harm, to anyone physically, and then also emotionally, you don't want to hurt anybody. So that's pretty simple to say yes or no to. Both, you know, everybody in my team, we all agree that certain products are no-nos, and we don't endorse those at all. As far as products that we've created and things that we're working on, it's all about passion. I think everybody here who's in business understands that just as much as I do, that if you have a passion for something and you love doing something, then, I mean, you're going to work hard because you love it. You're going to push it more. You're going to push it out there more than the next person who has the same item that you do, but there's no heart. So everything that we're working on is something that I believe in, my husband believes in, or my team.
So the view, I mean, the products that you support, they are environment friendly.
My cosmetic line, absolutely. No animals were hurt while making Starstruck.
You know, we love to know more personal side of you. You're a mother. You also do a lot of other charitable ventures. So tell us a little more about yourself. I mean, how do you sort of, I mean, there's so much responsibility on you in your own professional career, but as a person, and on your personal side, what is it that you like to do? What is it that you do?
Well, this morning I launched a art school slash learning center slash library. That's something my Daniel and I, if you didn't know his name, my husband and I have been working on for a while now. And our daughter has a passion for art and being creative. And so then we decided we should open up an art school. So that's what I was doing this morning. And I was using my magical chabuk, and I was getting everybody in line this morning, making sure everything was perfect. Being a mom is definitely, for mothers out there, and even fathers who are extremely active with their children, it's very difficult to keep children busy. How are you going to keep them busy? You put them in one place where they can learn, they can play, and they can also be creative. So that's what we're doing.
How did the art school idea really come up?
It came through our daughter, Nisha, who we adopted almost 2 years ago. And she has a real passion for painting and arts and crafts. I mean, if you walked into this little child's room, from floor to ceiling is all her artwork that she has worked on or made. And then I have drawers full of her artwork as well. So really the idea is simply her passion towards the arts.
How do you feel about Indian women, you know? What is your message to them if they were to be financially independent? How do they sort of, what do they need to do? How do they find the power in themselves? Because Indian women have typically been very homebred, and you know, they love to be in their homes, but it's important for a woman to be financially independent.
I think that's absolutely changing. Right now, I meet so many different women out there, and young girls, and different millennials who are aspiring to be something that that they, you know, dream of, or women out there who work extremely hard. So I think that that's absolutely changing, and it's probably about time we say that a woman's not oppressed anymore. She's working towards, you know, her own freedom as a woman, whether it's working or being a stay-at-home mom. I know I have a lot of respect to those women who stay home and take care of their children. It's not easy. Can I just say that? I'll say it again. It is not easy keeping children entertained all day and keeping them safe and feeding them and giving them baths and changing their diapers and doing those 1 million things that you have to do. So those stay-at-home moms, even though they're not, let's say, working in an office, they are definitely working extremely hard at home.
So Sunny, my question to you is that 10 years down the line, what do you see yourself doing? You have such a huge celebrity status today. And for women particularly, we've always known in Bollywood that, you know, once you sort of cross a certain age threshold, you have to be finding your own essence, your own power to be able to continue that celebrity status. So 10 years down, how do you see yourself? What do you see yourself doing? How do you want to, or what other areas of business or activities do you want to see yourself doing?
Well, I hope I'm still doing exactly what I'm doing today, is talking in front of amazing people who understand business and understand brand values and want to work towards making great products. That's where I see myself. Yes, being on screen does end at some point. I have no idea when that's gonna happen. It's usually when everything goes south here. the plan is to just work through these ideas and these creative thoughts that I have, or my husband has, or as a team collectively, that we think, okay, this is missing in the market, or this is something that we can tap into, and we know that people will respond well. You know, makeup is easy for me. Creating fragrances was easy for me. This school is absolutely amazing. Wasn't anything, but it's been so much fun when the doors open and you see children and they come in and they're playing, and it's amazing. I'm so excited about it because it just happened this morning. Sorry, guys. Obsessive, I know. And the next is, you know, lingerie, innerwear. Why does innerwear or lingerie have to be this big secret? Why can't it be this commercial idea that, let's say, a Victoria's Secret has created? No one here will say the word Victoria's Secret and go, ay, ye kya bol rahi hai, ye kya ho raha hai, ye lingerie ke baare mein baat kare, hai hai. No one's, why do we have to say that, oh, no, 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 I am not, wo storming, main nahi ja rahi hu. So these silly thoughts, I think, should end. It shouldn't be something that we should hide to do as women. I think we should be able to do that and say, okay, husband or boyfriend or friend, I know this is boring. I'll meet you in 20 minutes. I'm going to go buy myself some really nice lingerie or innerwear or loungewear, whatever it is, and be able to do that without feeling scrutinized. That's something that I'm very excited about.
Sunia, since morning, we've actually been talking about a lot of different form of content that is being produced today. And with OTT and digital platforms, there is a whole new opportunity that has opened up for content production. Do you see yourself doing something similar, maybe a series on a Netflix or an Amazon Prime? And do you see an opportunity for lots of other stars to be able to sort of maximize their time in prime time entertainment through them?
I think that anything digital is something that it's here. It's not happening, or it's not just beginning. It's here in India. There was a time where, you know, I would hear, oh, I don't know about digital, or oh, I don't know about being on social media, or oh, I don't know about this type of content, whether I should produce it or, you know, be a part of it, and it's going only out to the digital world. This is the time. If you're not on that train, you're gonna miss it. And I think that a lot of different celebrities out there or artists out there that aren't using this to its full capacity. I mean, they're just saying bye-bye crores of money. What's wrong with them? So I think that it's something that an artist or someone who wants to express themselves should definitely tap into this market if they haven't already. I know as a team and as our entire company, you know, digital is our base. This is, you know, this is where a lot of my viewerships come from, or a lot of our sales through Starstruck and Lust, which is a fragrance line, and Starstruck as well. You know, a lot of these things are sold online, and it does absolutely amazing. We're looking at, you know, one-click buys. You know, it's amazing. Or, you know, cash on delivery. Who doesn't love cash on delivery? The greatest thing ever. I mean, in America, they don't even have cash on delivery. I love it. So I think that if you're an artist out there, you're a celebrity out there, you're somebody who wants to get their voice out there, start using the tools that are right in front of you. And I think they should use it.